Welcome to BMC's Control-M installation video series. In this video, you will learn how to install Control-M server on UNIX using an Oracle database. This custom installation allows you to choose the database server, database names, usernames, host names, and port settings. If you want to install multiple instances of Control-M server on several computers using the same configuration, use the automatic installation, as described later in this video. A few things to know before you begin. The default installation is interactive and uses a GUI display. X server must be running and configured using the display environment variable. If you do not have the X server available, BMC recommends that you continue with the console installation or perform an automatic installation. Before you install, verify that your UNIX operating system and Oracle database software is compatible with the current version of Control-M Server. For a detailed list of UNIX and Oracle requirements, see the Control-M Help and Control-M Server release notes. In addition, if the site DBA does not want Control-M Server to have the Select Any Dictionary privilege, verify that the No Dictionary Environment variable is defined. To start the installation process, mount the installation DVD, or, from the temporary directory, extract the tar.z file. Next, set your display environment variable. From your home directory, run the setup.sh command. The Control-M installation wizard opens, which will guide you through the installation process. Read and accept the license agreement. Select Additional Installations and then select the Control-M Server option. To install with Oracle, select Custom Installation. In the Database Server Type screen, select Oracle. In the Database Server Connection screen, the Oracle Server hostname determines where the existing Oracle Database Server resides. The hostname can be local or an AWS RDS endpoint. Click Test to confirm its availability. Define the Oracle Listener port number and the Oracle Database service name. Due to security or organizational reasons, you might not be able to log into the Oracle Database server with the system user credentials during the Control-M server installation process. In this situation, before you install, the site database administrator needs to create the Control-M server user in the Oracle database. This is known as a non-system installation. For more information, see the Control-M help. In the database owner properties, enter the Oracle database owner, user, and password. And in the system administrator properties, enter the database administrator, user, and password. If this is a non-system installation, enter the database owner, username, and password provided by your site database administrator. Select the database size for the number of jobs that you intend to run on a daily basis. Ensure that there is enough available disk space for the selected database size on the external database server computer. By default, the table space name, size, and file name are populated. In the Control-M server configuration screen, the local IP interface name and the Control-M EMTCP IP communication, configuration agent, agent to server, and server to agent port numbers are set by default. If needed, change them within the valid port range. In the summary screen, review the installation details. If you want to install multiple instances of Control-M server on several computers using the same configuration, click Generate and select the location to create the XML parameter file. Copy the file to a network location that is accessible to all computers and run the installation script. For more information, see the Control-M help. Now, let's install. After the installation completes, close the current session and start a new one to start working with Control-M Server. The Control-M client is available on Windows only. To configure the automatic startup and shutdown script for Control-M Server, see the Control-M help. Thank you for watching this video.